Hello, welcome back. So this is just the place you arrive after you kill everything that you see on the pathway from the painting to here. It's quite a run. I mean, you have to fight, I don't know, about 15... Yeah, or 15 pans. Anyway, on the side of the bridge there is nothing except a gate and you need a float. Like the one that is singing in Remnant from the Ashes. So, let's go over here. I'll kind of show you what to do, by the way. I'm kind of injured. I died a lot of times, especially in the golem fight, so now I'm 39 and I'm almost dead. So when I die, I just want to see what the next perk will be. By the way, I choose the perk that will give me more of a chance to avoid or dodge their attacks. So as you can see, this is where they got the mechanics for the evasion. This is probably a shortcut. Hitler character. This seems so down. And this was kind of like a mirage over there. When I went through it, it changed. So there is no other way. I mean, this is a linear game. You don't have multiple pathways. You don't have multiple ways to do it. Yeah, we know those guys from Yaesha. The mummies. And now let's just go over here. I'll show you what I did. He seems to run a lot slower when he's wounded like that. I don't know. That's kind of a problem. So here we actually dropped a statue. Doesn't seem to do anything for now at least. So if you go on this pathway, you actually go up there and then you can drop the statue on this tomb over here. But looks like it doesn't do anything for now. So let's go back to the other side. We'll probably die, but I just wanted to show you how to kind of resolve this area. And here it was one of those elite creatures from Yaesha. The one with the storm colors, and they still use the storm. The internal matter sector from cadavers, okay. Yeah, this is how the Egyptians did it as well. The Green Pan Priest, the Karskan, what? Divined the long, okay. Outer shell, the skin, and the flesh. For the true life within the brain and organs. Okay, what's next? I guess they knew about anatomy. This is from Da Vinci's kind of drawing of the human. The whatever was, remove the whatever. Techniques and tools. The burial process approaches fine art. I would not say that. The winner but who's... Well, I guess we know what that guy was doing. He was preparing a new corpse. As you can see, they have a lot of tools over here. Some of them are in the book. So let's go down here and see what's up here. Well, except for certain death, because we have enough HP to take one hit and then die. Maybe not even one. Oh, this is the spear. I think, yeah, this is the spear that we also get in... Remnant from the Ashes. I forgot what it's called. Anyway, it's the Pan Spear. It does a little... the damage is a bit more closer to what I had before. This will be fun. Sadly, I'm not an agility character, because if I would be an agility character, this would have been perfect. A rope? How do you use, or where do you use the rope? Oh, okay, I get it. We have to use the rope on the statue we just dropped so we can go down there. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Well, more or less it makes sense, because if someone was playing the game and he didn't remember that, or, you know, they took a break, that would have been terrible. I guess I can use the spear once until I'm dead, because this doesn't do as much damage as my other stuff. Well, especially the hammer. The hammer seems to be the best weapon. I'm not sure about the maze-like nature of the game, because even though there is a lot of ground to cover, most of it is the same, more or less. We still have that other pathway to check, but I'm pretty sure there's nothing over there. Besides, usually you have to follow the pathway that has no enemies. Yeah, no enemies go there. So, we are back on Yaesha. It brings a lot of memory, right? The first time you reached Yaesha and Remnant from the Ashes felt like a magical place. I still don't know what to do with that little... Oh, it's not here. Okay, I get it. I mean, I was right about one thing. So the pan rope... with the palm embalming hook. So now we have a climbing rope. But I didn't check any guides for this. It's just that it's a little more natural. Amazing. Okay, apparently all of these were statues, no corpses. And now we are in the caves. Okay, look who's there. It's the guys that will kill me probably. I thought there was something in there, but apparently not. Now, you could try to attract only one of them. And that will work most of the times. Okay, we got one. And now let's kill him. Yes, we have the Yaesha spear, we have the... the Yaesha creatures. Looks like they are kind of vulnerable to the spear, because it's so fast and has a long reach. Well, if I'd known this, I would have won for the agility-based weapons, but that hammer was so useful. Like I said, this is where I died. Yeah, I was kind of expecting that. As you can see, their attacks don't really take into account the height or... where you are, so it's a little bit buggy either way. They're just like the fire little imps. AoE attack, ranged attack, kill, that's it. Okay, now let's see the special perk we get. Rude Awakening. Oh, okay, it was here. I just pressed too fast. Destructive talent, well, I guess this is for Arcane. Increasing your defense, stun bulwark. No, I want more defense. I don't know how much that added to my defense. Maybe it was nothing, but yeah, I'll not go for an Arcane build. Because you have to die a lot for that, and that will probably be a separate playthrough. I remember correctly, there are almost no enemies in this area either way. I almost want to rebind the space key that I use for running, but that would be too late right now. Yeah, it looks like the agility weapons are the best way to go, at least against these guys. But that's kind of, you know, cheating, because the hammer is so short range. Anyway, this is probably the first weapon that is actually used for ore that you get, because the... well, the Morning Star, but that's a little, you know, more like a decorative item, I feel like. And it was like the Wastelander flail, it was nice to look at, but very bad in combat. By the way, I actually tested this. You can fall down and die, so don't fall down and die, because the enemy will try to push off the ledge. I guess the guy with the lightning is a lot older, because he doesn't seem to see so well anymore. Oh, we gotta go, a little beard going. Well, that's how you grow a beard. Die until you reach 40. Yeah, the enemies seem to be very weak against certain weapons. Well, this makes the game 10 times easier. Okay, looks like we have to get the spear. And now the enemy... Now the game will give me an enemy that is very strong against that one. Oh, don't mind if I do, another dragon heart. He was so scared of what I was doing, he decided to stay in the shadows. Okay, this is a lot better than expected. And to be honest, investing in strength is not really worth it right now, because you get diminished returns after a while. So 32 is kind of like the place where you start getting less damage to your strength-based weapons. So I guess we can put more into this one. Oh, but now it costs me 2 points to upgrade one skill. Looks like agility and strength are kind of capped together, so 50 points and you need 2 points to continue upgrading. Oh, well, then I'll just go for more HP. 15 HP per point, at least for now. It looks like you're supposed to finish the game a lot earlier than this. This is kind of like the level you'll finish at. Some people finish at level 60, some people finish at level 50. It's not a very long game. Okay, we have opened the shortcut. Yeah, I would have went for the agility weapon if I had known. Oh wait, I forgot to actually get the next ability. Okay, let's get it right now. It's from the invisible wall over here. Well, after you pass through, it is no longer there. Thank you, dragon. I'll use this. A lightning stone. Well, that's better. And now let's go back and kill more people, or more pants. Now, this area looks to be clear anyway, so let's just go to the next one. So we got up the ladder. Well, this is an interesting looking thing. Weird. They have a lot of stuff going for them, but this is the weird one. Oh, the labyrinth box. Now, this sounds familiar. Yeah, let's open it. Labyrinth rune. Clever combination of both the key and the keyhole. Okay. Like I said, the main objective is to find the flute. The pan flute, or whatever it's called. More dragon oil, but I'm not sure why they would give you so much of it. I'm pretty sure no one will upgrade their weapon to the max because they want to try out the new weapons as well. Yeah, let's actually upgrade it, even though the damage is so... Well, agility, affinity... Oh, so that's why it does so little damage, because it doesn't have a lot of affinity, okay. By the way, look at the nice glow we are having with our flashlight. Oh, he's the pawn flute, is probably from the remnant from the ashes as well. He also has a sword near him. Okay, let's say hello.
Approaches. One of whose kind I have heard in whispers. It is Paxotec, foreign to the pan. Living beings require many things, Paxotec. Perhaps I will part with this possession. If the Paxotec proves itself worthy, the riddle shall I ask. Three chances shall it have. Pay heed, Paxotec.
Well, he has a big sword next to him. I don't want to fight him. I want to solve it peacefully because, you know, you don't want to kill musicians.
Alive I am not, yet still I grow. Lungs I have not, yet breathe.
You're a tree.
Not so clever. Disappointing, but not surprising.
Oh, it was a fire.
Know this, Paxotec. I take no pleasure in what I must...
Yeah, I wanted... Probably it was the fire. Wait, why doesn't it lock on him? Well, nice gameplay. Oop. I'm not sure what's going on, but didn't lock targets on him. I think we are supposed to die here. Oh, I saw blood. Okay, let's continue. Sorry about that. Maybe I read that too fast. It was probably a fire. Yeah, well. When I play a game, I'll promise I'll solve his reader. Weird. Why are we here? Well, we are here to finish the game, that's for sure. Oh, that's a direct drop. Okay, okay. And now let's fight two enemies at the same time. Also, let's see what this lightning stone does. It's probably more of the same, you know, enhancing your weapon, and that's about it. Don't try to sneak around, you can't sneak around these guys. Oh, I thought you did that from behind as well. Yeah, I'm a little disappointed in the magic. Doesn't seem to do much. Also disappointed in the weapons. They are clearly some that you must use in a zone and others that you must use in another zone. Which is not so bad, but I guess it's... Oh, these guys again. No, I really miss these guys. Even the same animations. as annoying as ever. Hmm, that's a nice little river. By the way, the trees are so good looking. I wish they would have imported the tree look into Remnant as well. Yeah, well, rest in peace. I hope they resurrect you or something. Still don't know what to do with the that thing or this thing. But I guess we'll learn until we finish the game. I could go for a swim, but I'm pretty sure we'll die, so no. Yeah, easy mode, right? And the spear, when it's enchanted with lightning like that, it's even better. Yeah, that was my mistake. You get so overconfident in this game, even on the hardest difficulty. Yeah, I thought it was too easy. Scratching my nose. Oh, they actually can attack each other. That's nice. Hmm, great combo this end, right? I guess the Cruel are actually a bigger threat than the Pan. Okay, you can go for a few more minutes. Let's kill one of the bigger guys. Looks like we have to go into the other direction because this is the way you finish the level, probably. Not much to do with my points except HP at this moment. Hey, that's one of the guys they actually showed in the trailers, I think. Also, you don't get staggered. Or not as fast as the other ones. Well, I totally... that was weird and fun at the same time. Yeah, let's go back and explore the other way. Is that the master key? Yeah, it looks like it is. Okay, let's go the other way. When I see this place, I always think of it as a lot of pen and a lot of guns, but now no. Just the spear. Well, I guess they could kind of remake this level to be playable in Remnant from the Ashes and you can only play with melee weapons. That would have been cool. Like introducing a game mode called, I don't know, Kronos in Remnant from the Ashes and you'd only have the melee weapons to go through Yaisha. So does this planet have a sun or two suns or three suns? Okay, now this is probably the weird part of the game because we were probably going to a cave or something. Oh, you're alive! Oh, I pressed the wrong key. Well, I'm happy to see these guys alive, but I pressed the wrong key. Okay, let's try that again, and this time we'll actually be more careful. Yeah, it seems like it doesn't really matter how much defense you have, how much HP you have, you'll still get killed so fast. It's not a difficulty either. I think this is how the game was programmed. You know, very hard, but very short. I mean, once you know where to go... Oh, I'm not fighting all of this again. Well, count yourselves lucky, guys. I know how to dodge those, I played so much. They even seem to have the same trajectory as before, as in Remnant. Come on, guys, you're no snipers. Well, fight me at least. Well, this makes the games a lot easier. I don't even have to think about what I'm doing. Looks like those guys quit anyway. And figure that, I had 3 health left. 3 heals left. That doesn't really matter. Healing seems to be an afterthought in the game. Well, let's just wash away the blood from our weapons, because now we have a source of water. Oh, that was a frog. I thought someone was sleeping in here. Another trip with Ford and the team through the Delta. Today we found ourselves in a beauty whatever crafted village. In the treetops. Yeah, the forest is beautiful, present an aurora, but haven't engaged us. They appear to be intelligent. To the mythical pan from the folklore and fairy tales, it's easy to become enchanted with our surroundings. Yeah, not sure what they're doing. Day 2. The team made it to the ground level of the forest this morning. A ridge approached, surrounding us, their weapons were drawn, and they had us cornered at the edge of the ridge. Backed into a cave. Left inside a harn, but they are looking at us, and they have guards. Flipping shifts. No, everything is not in control. So the two guards rushed in into the cave and grabbed. Only two guards, and you let them grab him. One of our men was killed in exchange. The captain was brought back. Oh, come on, you lost a man. You lost someone because of a stupid misunderstanding. Unsuccessful, and they seem very angry about our presence. The cave is still guarded. Yeah, whatever. They're running out of food and water, the natives have gathered to perform chants and rituals. And he believes we will not survive. Something grandmother told you about plastic, so we have a keycard. We have a keycard from Ford. Ward 16. Well, that just might be part of the lore or something, but... was there a door in the ward that we couldn't open? I think there was a... Okay. It's all coming back. So we have a ward door that we couldn't open. Anyway, that's enough for today. See you tomorrow. Bye.